our deen. And also we have shown you, second, that our knowledge can always be increased. And lastly, we have shown you why we say, well, what is the importance of cultural awareness and respect. So what should be done now? Ladies and gentlemen, what we should do right now is that we should spread cultural awareness and respect. And this process can be done through two processes. First is through exposure. Ladies and gentlemen, exposure number one is through the surrounding community. For example, if you go to school and you are surrounded by friends or culturally diverse friends, and when you go to work, you are surrounded by culturally diverse colleagues. And then when you go back to your home, your neighborhood is a culturally diverse neighborhood. So this shows that you can be exposed to different cultures through your surrounding community. But what if you do not have a surrounding community which is culturally diverse? For example, the respondents in our research, which do not have friends from other cultures, but are willing to increase their knowledge about other cultures, that can be done through the National Open House Program, which the government organized. Ladies and gentlemen, the National Open House Program acts as a platform for us to know and better get familiar with other cultures when we are not surrounded by a culturally diverse surrounding. Last but not least, through traveling. You can spread cultural awareness and respect through traveling by immersing yourself in another culture when you go traveling. Not over, it has its leisurely purpose, but it also has its educational purposes by spreading cultural awareness and respect. Secondly, is through educating the mass. First and foremost, the campaign. Most of our respondents have agreed that the One Malaysia campaign endorsed by the government is one of the reasons why they became aware that cultural awareness and respect is important in generating world unity. So this shows that campaigns are effective in educating the mass about spreading cultural awareness and respect. Secondly, is through school curriculum, for example, the civic subject, which provides theoretical knowledge for you about cultural awareness and respect. And also, next, the co-curricular activity, which act as a field for you to test that theoretical knowledge. Now, last but not least, the printed and electronic media. Ladies and gentlemen, it's undeniable about the role of printed and electronic media in educating the mass. Because almost always, what the media is talking about is always what we are talking about. So this shows that printed and electronic media plays an important role and a very crucial role in spreading cultural awareness and respect. So ladies and gentlemen, may I remind you that even if we attend every single national open house there is, or even if we travel to the end of the world, or even if the media does not show any single news except for news about cultural awareness and respect, cultural awareness and respect still cannot be enhanced, cannot be increased, if there is not one important element, which is paradigm shift. Ladies and gentlemen, right now, in this day and age, what we have found is that two mindsets of our community which have to be shifted. Firstly, the mindset of thinking that we know everything there is to know about a certain culture. Hence, we have the right to criticize or to judge that particular culture. Ladies and gentlemen, this has to be